In order to establish what shots were needed for our music video, we firstly created a paper-based storyboard that we then filmed later on a Sony NX5 in order to create our digital animatic. We soundforged to cut the track in order to make the animatic process more manageable. We then used Final Cut Pro in order to cut the animatic. This helped us to establish how the transitions would happen between the narrative and performance elements of our real music video, as well as help us realise the variety of shots that we needed in order to hold the audience's attention for the duration of our video.
In order to match the lip syncing with the track, we used a digital clapper on an iPad for the shoot. It also worked as a playback so that when we pressed the button, the music would start and a time code would be running alongside, so that we used multiple video channels when editing the lip syncing throughout all of the rushes for matching the music lyrics.
We wanted to have a band image similar to the Black Eyed Peas. Therefore, it was essential that we screen tested the main artists in our music video so that we could get the dynamics of the group right. We did this by using our iPhones in the studio, asking them to lip sync along with the track that was being played out loud using portable Bluetooth speakers.
At this point in the music video, someone walked into the background of the shot where the three artists judges are watching auditions. Luckily, the background behind them is still, and this enabled us to use masking to take him out. We took a screen picture of how the set looked like just before he came on. Then, when he did walk on, we pasted the image on top so that he didn't appear and made it look like nothing had changed.
We filmed using a Sony EVPAS 100, which had multiple lenses that we could use in order to create the most effective shots. This worked by measuring the distance between the camera and the object that we wanted to focus on, so that our camera shots looked more professional.
As you can see, we had quite a large cast. In order to keep in contact with everyone about the shooting day schedule and costumes, we kept in touch via Facebook, where we had everyone in a group and could send out messages that everyone could easily access.
All of our music video was edited using Final Cut Pro. For our music video, the narrative played a very important role, therefore we needed to do multiple takes on the shooting day. When we had to edit our performance, we had to separate all the takes in multiple different channels. In order to find the best performance clips for the music video, we had to pull back and forward individual clips to find one best suited for the point of the music video. We did this by putting markers on the beat and blading off clips when we had found the right one.
The final stages of our editing involved us using a software called Color. This enabled us to enhance the primary colours, make them come a lot brighter. This was a very important finishing task for our music video because we wanted our music video to be energetic, youthful and vivid. Therefore, having the colours enhanced, especially during the party scene, allowed us to portray the image across to our audience.
We wanted our finished media product to reach as many people as possible in order to receive feedback, which would then help us establish whether it was a success or not. Firstly, the video was put onto YouTube, but later the music video was embedded onto our blogs and posted on various Facebook profiles in order to receive a large worldwide audience. We also went around and filmed people giving us feedback to our music video, which we turned into one single clip and later uploaded to our blog.